everybody. Today we are here to congratulate Ashwathi Nair. Ashwathi got into King's College London, Queen Mary, Liverpool, Nottingham, and Royal College of Surgeons in Ireland for medicine program. Ashwathi goes to Dubai American Academy and is an IB diploma student right now. And now she is going to start her medicine at the King's College London, right?
Yeah.
From September of 2017. So, congratulations.
Thank you.
So, Ashwathi, why don't you share a little bit about you know, your journey in the last couple of years, what all you and your family had to do to make sure you get into your dream college?
So I had decided at the beginning of high school that I wanted to do medicine. So ever since then, I started preparing my profile by doing extracurricular activities and being part of leadership roles in my school. And then after that, about 2 years ago, I contacted you guys to do a try Ukcat exam, which really helped me because it gave me an idea of where I stand and how much I need to prepare for the next year. And once I did that, I applied for all these four universities. And once I got interview calls, I prepared once again for the multi-mini interviews with the mentors at Brighter Prep, as well as with my family, just practiced different questions and how to present myself and stuff like that. And once that was done, I was just waiting for doing my IB exams, and now I'm waiting to get my results.
So, as Ashwathi mentioned, I mean, there are a lot of things one has to do to apply to colleges in terms of, you know, preparing for the Ukcat, personal statement, selection of colleges, and then multi-mini interview, and also get good grades in your high school exams.
Yes.
So, Ashwathi, I would like you to share with, you know, our students and students across the world who are planning to apply for medicine, what sort of a roadmap they should come up with, you know, to reduce the stress and to better their time management?
I think the most important thing is to have a plan from, as you said, a roadmap from the beginning, because that takes away a lot of the stress and anxiety that you may feel because you feel unprepared. So for me, once I contacted you guys, I had a 2-year timeline of what all I need to do and how I need to prepare. And the way I did it was take it one step at a time. So I started by just thinking about doing the trial Ukcat exam. And then once that was done, thinking about doing my applications and writing my personal statement. Because that way I was less stressed and overwhelmed at all times. Because if you're thinking about all the different things you need to do before you can finally get into medical school, it can be really stressful and overwhelming. So I would say take it one step at a time.
Right. So I understand that, you know, all the students who are applying for medicine, they are intelligent students and they all have good grades like you did. So how did you make sure that your application stood out? What did you do to make it look more appealing to the colleges you applied to?
I think it's twofold. One of the things I did was, as I mentioned, be very involved in school activities and take part in MUN and extracurricular activities and even the student government in my school, because that allows me to present myself as an all-rounded person rather than somebody who's just good at giving exams and doing well in school. And other than that, I think the personal statement is the place where you can really shine and show who you are as a person. Because when I first wrote my personal statement, it was just a list of things that I had done and achieved, which is not what the universities want to see, because they can see that through your application in general. But later I talked more about why I was passionate about medicine, why I decided that I wanted to go into this field, what made me make that decision. So that allowed me to present a more personal and humane side of myself rather than just an application with a number.
Fantastic. So apart from, you know, all these extracurricular activities which you did you do anything specific, you know, which showed your interest in the field of medicine and which showed that you had some clinical experience, etc., before you applied to colleges?
Yes, definitely. I did 3 internships / doctor shadowings in different hospitals in Dubai and India, and that allowed me to show them that I am invested in getting in and I have done the preparation, because other than any other field, medicine is something that's really hard to get experience in before you actually get into the field. So those experiences were really valuable, and I think they did add a lot to my application.
Great. So I would like to highlight once again that Ashwathi got interview calls from, you know, all the four colleges she applied to in the UK. Rather five, because I think you did a separate application to University of Central Lancashire as well,
yes,
which accepts international students, and international students can apply separately to UCLAN outside the UCAS. So you did five different multiple mini interviews, right? So why don't you share with you know, students, how were they different from each other, and what sort of stations, different, you know, sections of the interview they had, and how did you prepare yourself?
So since it's multi-mini interviews, each of the interviews lasts about 2 hours and has different stations, 7 to 8 stations, each about 8 minutes long. And each of the interviews had similar stations like leadership, communication, and just the basics of ethics and anything that you would expect of somebody going into the medical profession. But each of them also had their own unique stations. For example, some of the places like Nottingham University had role play, where you had to interact with somebody who's acting to be a patient, and you had to be a volunteer student or somebody and walk them through some process. And other stations were looking at your ability to multitask. So I had to build a 3D giraffe, I think, while answering their questions.
Okay.
Well. So there are things that you can't prepare for.
Alright, so just to better understand, you were answering the question and you were using blocks to...
to build the picture given to me at the same time.
Interesting.
Which is quite stressful. But I think there are definitely a lot of things that you can prepare for. Because especially, it's really difficult to get everything that you want to say in those 6 minutes without digressing and saying things that are not relevant. So practicing with people around you and your teachers and your parents is really useful to get concise and to the point and make yourself very clear.
Fantastic. So Ashwathi, thanks for all the information. I'm sure it's very, very useful. And I mean, if you guys have more questions, if you want to know more about the process, you can definitely contact us or even Ashwathi, you know, and I'm sure we will be more than happy to help you. So thank you so much. Congratulations once again.
Thank you.
And good luck for your journey.
Thank you.